How's it going, everyone? Welcome back to another review on the Film Nerd Reviews channel. Today we are looking at X-Men Days of Future Past. Now, no face cam today, I need to get this one out nice and quickly, but it will be returning, don't worry, at some point. But it's kind of just like, anyway, that's for another video. But today we're talking about X-Men Days of Future Past. Now, as much as I did say in the First Class review that First Class was my favourite, I think it's really hard to pick one between this and First Class, because both of them are the top tier movies in this franchise, top tier, and I think it might just be because this one cracks slightly above that in having the old cast and the new cast, as well as having James McAvoy as Professor X, Michael Fassbender as Magneto, and Jennifer Lawrence as Mystique, as well as Nicholas Holt as Beast. You have the old cast back, including but not limited to Patrick Stewart as Professor X, Ian McKellen as Magneto, Halle Berry as Storm, Elliot Page, then Ellen Page as Kitty Pryde, Anna Paquin as Rogue, but only for very brief moments at the very, very end of the film, although there is a world cut version of the film with her in it more. Sean Ashmore back as Iceman, Famke Janssen is back as Jean Grey, James Madison is back as Cyclops, and then Kelsey Grammer is back as Beast as well. So it is cool to see all these people back, as well as the new and the old, and although there isn't a scene in the standard cut between young Magneto and old Magneto, I don't actually know if there is one in the world cut. There might be, but don't quote me, because I don't actually know. But yeah, as it goes as a whole, I do adore Days of Future Past. I think bringing the old and the new together, not only that, but this trailer is actually a really, really good trailer. If you listen to it outside of, if you watch it outside of the context of this review, it's a really good trailer. But I think it's just great to see Patrick Stewart and James McAvoy share a scene together is fantastic. I think the whole 70s setting is really fun. I just think it's a really well put together movie that is just so, by far, one of the better movies of this franchise. Like, literally one of the best movies of this franchise, out of all of them. And I think there's a lot that the others could potentially learn from this one, including, you know, stuff like getting characters accurate, having a well developed script. But I think the story as a whole is really brilliant, and especially towards the end it gets really, like, super good. Well, not super good, but you know what I mean, it gets really fun and it gets really dramatic, which not all movies can pull that off well, especially with the cast of characters this movie has. But it manages to pull it off absolutely fantastically, and I just think it is such a good movie. And yeah, I just think, as a whole, it's a brilliant, it's just a movie that really has such great characters built in such a way as well, that it really just remains to be seen how much better it could get, you know. I genuinely think it's one of the most underrated movie. Well, not underrated, because it's very, very good. It's not underrated like the Wolverine or like the Wolverine in particular. I think the Wolverine is my third favourite X-Men movie behind these two. I love the Wolverine. But yeah, it's just so much fun. It's just so brilliantly crafted. I think Bryan Singer did a great job with this one, and although maybe he didn't do the greatest job with its sequel, Apocalypse, which is set up in this movie, I think Hugh Jackman as Wolverine is fantastic again. as he always is. And it's really great to see the story be so contradictory in its own nature as well, including several things, including the fact that William Stryker was portrayed as being a slightly older man in First Class, which is takes place 10 years prior to this movie, but in this movie he's portrayed as being a much younger man, so you go with that. And also stuff like, apparently, Professor Xavier just loses his powers. I know that's explained in the movie, but, you know, there are some inconsistencies, I'm not gonna lie to you, there always will be, but that's not to say it isn't full of just absolute brilliant moments as well, as most movies like this do. Like, I generally think it is full of first class shit, like seriously first class stuff. And I just think you're not going to get a better X-Men movie than this one in every single regards of the word. Because I think it's so meticulously well crafted that you just don't suspect you know what I mean? It's just so magnificently made, and I adore First Class and First Class and Days of Future Past. A lot of people say that it's very similar to Infinity War in terms of the Infinity War of the X-Men franchise, and to that I say it is far, far better than Infinity War in my personal opinion. But that's not to say that Infinity War is the worst movie I've seen, because it's not. It's just, I personally believe there are better movies out there than this one particularly. I guess it's just one of those things where I do love Days of Future Past. I think it is something incredibly special, incredibly well crafted, a movie that doesn't come around very often, and just to be such a marvel, no pun intended, of how to bring different generations of characters together. It is so great to see the old people back. That's, you know, it is so good to see the old cast back as well, to cherish those little moments. Like, especially towards the end, there's a scene where Magneto says to Charles, that we spent all those years fighting just to get a few back towards the end, which is really nice. And I think it is such a brilliantly crafted movie, and I do like the ending where Wolverine realizes everything is okay, everyone's alive, and he goes through the house, and that is when Rogue makes her tiny cameo in the theatrical release cut of this movie, although there is much more with Rogue in this movie. But yeah, I just adore everything about this movie, and I think I have to admit, Bolivar Trask is also played brilliantly by Peter Dinklage. I think he's one of the best villains I've in this X-Men franchise as well. Yeah, it's just a fantastic movie, and I probably would watch it. It's currently streaming on Disney Plus in the United Kingdom. I'm not aware of it streaming on Disney Plus elsewhere, but it is in the UK. So yeah, thanks so much for watching my review of X-Men Days of Future Past, the theatrical cut. Tune in tomorrow for my review of Fantastic. Not looking forward to it. But yeah, thanks so much for watching. Have a wonderful day. Don't forget to check out all the other videos. Check out the music as well. We've got a new EP launching on the 1st of March, 2022. I announced that on the 1st of February. It will be at the end of this video as the teaser and the track list. So enjoy that. And thanks so much for watching. Have a wonderful day. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Bye-bye for now.